Hello guys and girls, I'm Reef Ben. Today we're going to talk about magnesium. Magnesium is atomic number 12. It's a gray, shiny, metallic metal, just like other things we looked at, calcium, potassium, all metals. Unlike those two though, magnesium is very unreactive. So while magnesium is the ninth most abundant element in the universe, it is the third most abundant ion in water after sodium and chloride. And it is so abundant in seawater because it's very unreactive. And it's so unreactive that an ion of magnesium will actually spend several tens of millions of years floating around in the water on average before it is bound up into something else. And that's a function of how much there is in the water, but also how unreactive it is. Magnesium is actually about 5 times more abundant in the water than calcium. But the way we normally measure it, parts per million, is a measurement of weight. And the magnesium atom is so much lighter than a calcium atom. So by parts per million, it's only about 3 times more abundant than calcium, or around 1300 to 1400 parts per million magnesium in water. You can see magnesium is a gray, shiny crystal. And unlike calcium, unlike potassium, it doesn't do anything when you drop it into water. Magnesium is chemically very similar to calcium, so much so that the reactions that our coral use to build their skeletons that normally use calcium often instead use magnesium, just because it's available in the water and takes the place of calcium. This means that the amount of magnesium in your water sort of will go up and down with the amount of things growing in that water. The more coral and algae you have, the more SPS or coral that needs to build skeletons, the more magnesium is going to be taken out of the water just by nature of it sort of getting in the way of calcium in those reactions. That's not necessarily harmful for the thing that is doing it, but that's the primary use of magnesium in our tanks. Since there is so much magnesium in seawater, fish have actually developed specific chemical processes that go on in their kidneys to excrete excess magnesium from their bodies. Otherwise, since it's in the food they eat, it's in the water that they breathe and swim around in, they would just build up in their bodies over time. So they need a specific way to export it from their bodies, and they do that through their kidneys. Magnesium is actually also very important in the ability of seawater to buffer itself. And that's really part of the reason why seawater is so often between about 8.0 to 8.5 on the pH scale. Magnesium binds up with carbonate in the water, and this prevents calcium carbonate from falling out of solution, from precipitating, when it otherwise would. Since the magnesium is in the water, there can be much more calcium carbonate in the water than there otherwise would be able to be. And that's why seawater is in the pH range that it is, because of the calcium carbonate that's able to be there only because magnesium gets in the way of it precipitating out. The way calcium carbonate would precipitate out of water is to form little crystals. And what actually happens is magnesium ends up coating the surface of those crystals chemically and interfering with another layer of calcium carbonate being laid down. And that's how it manages to keep so much in solution. So I mentioned coral and algae. That's actually the number one thing that uses magnesium in our tanks. So much so that coral and algae can be up to 4% magnesium by weight. Any other calcification process, like the building of coral skeletons or coral and algae growing, things like that. Any calcification process in our tank is going to use magnesium to some extent. And that's why it's important to have at least some magnesium in your tank. It's very difficult to overdose magnesium to the point that it becomes toxic. There is some information online where they use magnesium concentrates above 8,000 parts per million to help like harvesting oysters and things like that. But it's very hard to actually get to that level unless you're just dumping a magnesium supplement into your tank. So it's not necessarily something you have to worry about having too much of. There are some salt mixes that are low in magnesium, and so it is important to maybe measure your magnesium level in general, but it's probably unlikely to be a huge source of problems for you unless you're dosing it maybe without knowing it. Maybe it's high in something that you're dosing. It could be high in calcium supplements, actually. Some calcium supplements add magnesium, or it could be high in the type of food you're feeding. And so that could be adding calcium to your tank without you knowing about it, or not calcium, magnesium to your tank without you knowing about it. And also some salt mixes have additional magnesium added to it, and some are also low. So it's good to measure. It is a easy test to do. All of the major test kit brands have a magnesium test. You should definitely know what it is, and especially know your tank's level before you start dosing it. You want to keep magnesium around 1300 to 1400 parts per million. As I mentioned, significant overdosings can cause trouble, but most of your magnesium is likely to actually come from the salt mix that you add. If you do need to raise it, sometimes it used to be that you could use Kent Marine Tech M to dose to get rid of bryopsis. That has actually not worked because it's not actually the magnesium that kills bryopsis. It was an impurity in their mix that did it, and they've since changed their mix and it no longer works. Brightwell Marine makes a magnesium supplement now that does still work. It's called Hydrate MG. And that mix has whatever that impurity was that killed off bryopsis. So if you need to get rid of bryopsis in your tank, you can use Hydrate MG from Brightwell Aquatics. Raise your magnesium using that up to about 1500 parts per million and leave it there for a few weeks, dose as needed to maintain it, and you'll find that your bryopsis will actually die off. It might be easier though to use a drug called fluconazole to do this. That's an anti-parasite actual drug. You can buy it online if you search for it. You can find information on like Reef to Reef, things like that for dosing fluconazole. If you do test your tank, you find that you're significantly below 1300 to 1400 magnesium, you can go ahead and raise it. Use any commercial magnesium supplement to do that. Just be careful that you don't raise it by 500 parts per million all of a sudden. Like anything in reefing, small changes add up over time. Maybe only raise it by 50 or 100 parts per million a day, and then once you reach your actual level that you're targeting, just hold it there and continue dosing that, whatever that amount is for your tank. I hope this was interesting. I'd be interested to know if you've had magnesium trouble or not. I hope it was interesting, and I will see you next time. Bye.